One in seven people around the world has some kind of disability. Being born without my right hand has defined who I am over the past 30 years. I was fortunate to grow in the sacred valley of the Incas in Cusco, Peru, surrounded by people who weren't surprised to see me driving my bike or probably playing basketball. When I was seven, I remember being stunned after I watched Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, when Luke's hand gets cut off, the same one I didn't have. But then being twice as stunned when the medical robots fitted him with a prosthesis that could move and feel. From then on, no greater purpose lived in my mind, which was to have a prosthesis like Luke Skywalker. This dream led me to study mechatronics engineering and access the biomechanics and applied robotics laboratory in Pontifical Catholic University of Peru, where, with a multidisciplinary team, we developed a myoelectric prosthesis for long transradial amputation, being me the pilot user. I was able to move each finger individually, and also we develop a way in which we get to pass the sensation from the fingertips into my forearm using haptic feedback system. Since this was a research project, we had enough funding to buy stuff from abroad. So for example, the motors you get to see here were all brought by Switzerland. This is one of the main reasons why it will cost at least $40,000 to make this prosthesis. But 40K is way too much, considering that 4 out of 5 people with upper limb amputation live in developing countries. Even the $25,000 that costs a robotic prosthesis imported from abroad is way too much. In Peru, that is equivalent to work full-time on a minimum wage for almost 7 years, just to buy the prosthesis. Never mind pay for your food or your house. It is often that people get injured while doing manual labor activities, like farming or metal manufacturing. Getting back to work and having access to money demands a functional hand. It took me time to realize what a huge privilege I had to study a career that would help fulfill my dreams. But actually, what was preventing me from developing a solution that was both affordable and functional? The very first step in order to reduce the cost was to reduce the number of motors, because they were all imported and therefore expensive. So we get to arrange occupational focus groups with our amputee volunteers in order to identify which gestures they will use the most, and of those, how many we could perform using just a single motor. The answer was 3: pinch, cylindrical, and lateral. This also helps us to reduce the number of electromyographic sensors too. From an arrangement of 8, we pass just to 1. In this way, between mix in our mechanical and myoelectric prosthesis, the prices will be dramatically low. But material prices matter too. And that's why we choose to 3D print our prosthesis using mainly plastic from recycled bottles, like the prosthesis I am wearing right now. In order to develop our prosthesis, the process will go like this. First, we will use our 3D scan and our own parameterization software in order to take the measures of the amputated area and the other hand of the user. Then, we'll recreate the entire set of fingers, the palm, and the prosthesis socket in our computational model to finally 3D print each of those parts. So far, in Lab Bionics, we have 2 types of prosthesis: Maki, which is a mechanical activation, and Pisco, with electronic activation. Pisco costs just 10% of an imported robotic prosthesis that will come from abroad. This means that even more working-class people can access to our technology. For me, this has been a path where I was able to develop this in my company, Lab Bionics. So for example, take Franco, which now is using his transradial Maki prosthesis in order to get back to work with his providers on the jungle farm he has. I am certain that we are able to be on a side with technology that is brought from abroad to our region, being sold in a very expensive way. We have the capacity to develop our own technology, having the necessities of our people in mind. So then people with disabilities and limited resources could live a life again. For me, when people, our users, get back to work on their places, that look of compassion changed to astonishment. The same astonishment which I had when I saw Luke Skywalker's prosthesis. So this began as a path for myself, but it now belongs to my entire region. Would you like to join us? Thank you so much.